XFM News. On point.
Take a look at the news. Government officers in the urban sector have been told to focus on urban communities if the nation is to have strong and well-planned cities. Vincent Viendaimira, the Director of Physical Planning and Development in the Lands Ministry, noted that although only 20% of the population works in urban areas, the country is urbanizing at a 5% rate annually, which has placed it among the world's quickest growing cities. Viendaimira said if all the actors did not compromise the efforts, the nation would have achieved a 30% urban growth by 2030. He was speaking ahead of the commemoration of World Cities Day, slated for 31st.
I call upon all actors in the urban sector to focus their efforts on urban communities, the vulnerable, innovators, developers, environmental conservationists, and many others whose contributions build and strengthen their respective cities, to do the following: to enhance collaborations, especially with the local communities, to promote Sustainable Development Goal 11 on sustainable cities and communities in order to develop sustainable cities for all in Uganda.
Now, police in Rubanda District is holding a man on allegations of murdering his own father. Eli Mate, Chigezi Region Police spokesperson, identifies the suspect as Orisha Bamedit, suspected to have killed his father, Rubahimbia Henry, of Kanyamatembe Village, Nyarurambi Ward, Rwanda Town Council. Mate said the incident happened on 22nd and the suspect's father died on the 25th after he was admitted to Mbarara Regional Referral Hospital. Olshaba then fled and was tracked down and arrested by Bujuko Police in National Division with the help of the Rwanda team. He adds that Olshaba is now pending transportation back to Rwanda, where he will be tried, from appealing to people to receive guidance from their leaders rather than taking the law into their hands.
I want to condemn this act. Once you have children, you are supposed to be assured of personal security, but to see that it's his own biological son terminating his own father's life, it's very unbelievable. Something we can't accept. People violating others' rights to that level, that's why we must do everything possible so that he's taken before courts of law and answer charges accordingly.
Now, with heavy rains that have continued to hit Tesla sub-region, over 40 villages have been affected by the flooding of Lake Choga in Kalaki District. The villages are from the sub-counties of Kakure, Buluku, and parts of Kalaki that are near Lake Choga. Five of the villages with over 200 households are affected in Kakure sub-county, 32 villages in Bululu sub-county, and the rest of the villages are in Kalaki sub-county. Of the affected households, over 30 families have been forced to relocate to the churches, while others are being hosted by their relatives. Most houses and crops like rice and sorghum, among others, have been submerged in water, and residents are expecting famine next year. Samuel Akel, the local council 5 chairperson, confirms that over 3 roads in the district are currently impassable.
And it's beyond our reach. Food is not there, and people are displaced. Some are being hosted in churches. So it is a serious matter. But unfortunately, I also don't know where the government is hard up. And it is beyond the district. What is near now, the district cannot handle. A road cut off. So it is a big challenge for us as a district. In Bululu alone, over 32 villages were affected. And Akure, in one parish, like Opumure, over 200 households are affected. Over 5 villages are affected in Opumure parish. It's a big challenge. So in the all the 3 sub-counties, we have close to 40 villages affected. With it being affected, where you see water has covered the home, the compound, and that is the challenge we're in. And what we are only doing is really come to our rescue. Very challenging. It's not that easy, because also now what do you do? You can't walk on the road, and the water is still there and seems to be coming.
In other news, Tanzanians are for the fourth day having difficulties accessing social media sites. Since Tuesday morning, WhatsApp users have been failing to download photos or videos and can only send and receive text messages via the chat application. Twitter is also down and can only be accessed via VPN. The access to Instagram and YouTube is also restricted as the country's general election results continue to stream in. The affected are Twitter, WhatsApp, Instagram, and Google services. Carlton VPN, an open source VPN provider, said on Twitter that the authorities were now trying to block VPN services. People went to the polls this week in the general election, where President John Pombe Magufuli, who has been accused of clamping down on public freedoms, is seeking a second five-year term. And that was the news. XFM News.